I will present my study, its impact of a family-based educational intervention on knowledge, attitude, and burden of Alzheimer caregivers. And in my introduction, as you know, globally, life expectancy rises and chronic conditions associated with aging are becoming more prevalent, especially Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer accounts for 50% of dementia cases, and it is a challenging issue as it is identified by Alzheimer's Disease International 2018. It's now recognized as Alzheimer dementia type, poses serious public health threats, and globally there are like 47 million people living with dementia. Number of them has been predicted to rise to 75 million by 2030 and 102 million by 2050, which something is miserable, okay, to listen about this big number. Family caregivers, okay, or hereafters, or as they've been named, have been have an expanded role in this context to provide support to caregiver communities of practice, maybe suitable a solution for them. There is a wealth of literature that illustrate how learning and information sharing can happen in community context, especially with Alzheimer patients, which is a major form of neurocognitive impairment among seniors over 65 years old, affecting many of them. By 2050, the Alzheimer Association estimates that the global Alzheimer prevalence may reach for 68%. Approximately 130,000 people in Saudi Arabia have Alzheimer disease. And this is nowadays, okay, according to Saudi Alzheimer Association. The Institute of Health Metrics and Evaluation ranked Alzheimer disease as one of the most common causes of death in 2016. Worldwide, love and devotion are expressed in the caregiver role. As a result, the family system places an important emphasis on supporting each other. Alzheimer disease diagnosis and assessment can be stressful for the caregiver from mental, physical, and financial perspective. So in order to help their family, those families and caregiver managing their beloved Alzheimer patient, families and caregiver, we believe that they need to understand what triggers the behavior of Alzheimer patient, what is the problem arises due to lack of medical knowledge, social skill, emotional skills, and which make it difficult for them to provide care for their patients. The level of perception of Alzheimer and the burden of family caregiver has not been measured, and the attitude assumed by the caregiver toward Alzheimer disease can determine how much an investment is made in the care, possibly increasing emotional distress and burden among them. In the learned helplessness model, the experience of negative outcome can be attributed to cognitive attribution or explanation, and the caregiver stress model proposed by Berlin et al. Relied on the family network, cultural background, personal history to a model impacting stress on caregiver lives. Furthermore, there are difficulties related to employment, family, social life, finance, and some intrapsychic issue like self-esteem and control. It was reported to the family caregivers that they were not getting any medical support and community resources for the management of Alzheimer disease. The significance of the study, our rationale why we're conducting this study in Saudi Arabia, despite the high prevalence of this destructive disease, there are a shortage of Alzheimer Association and the healthcare provider in Saudi Arabia. Unfortunately, and despite the Saudi Arabia is a highly economic country, okay, but still mental health people having mental illness diseases and this Alzheimer still stigmatized. So they call like negative affecting the patient caregiver because they are unaware by these problems. They don't know where they can go with their patient. They don't know. Some of them, they live with their families, okay, and they presented these symptoms for Alzheimer without knowing that the patient or their this old age or this senior in the family having Alzheimer. As a result, Alzheimer families caregiver feel burdened nationally or internationally. In addition, there is a lack of consultant and an institution who can manage these difficulties. As I mentioned, during this celebration, the Saudi Arabian Minister of Health announced that they have like 103,000 cases of Alzheimer disease, and the incidence double every 5 years for the people having or above age of 65. This number of cases is projected to nearly treble to 14 million people by 2060. They also confirm that Alzheimer disease is not a part of normal aging and education, and that may help reducing the risk of such disease. As far we know, the family caregiver did not attend the awareness program, which does not exist in the Saudi Arabia a lot. And I think regarding this issue, we hold like many campaigns. Okay, and we discovered that a lot of people did not know about this Alzheimer, and they listen for Alzheimer as a magic thing. Okay, so we found that few studies have been conducted in this research area. Okay, due to stigma, due to lack of an institution, due to lack of awareness program, and many things, right? And then this is why we conduct this current study aiming at examining the effect of a specific educational intervention on improving Alzheimer caregiver knowledge and attitude, and exploring how it reduces their subjective burden. And we try to answer the following questions. How do knowledge, attitude, and burden level of Alzheimer disease differ between pre and post intervention? And how do the participant demographic details impact their knowledge, attitude, and the burden level regarding the Alzheimer disease? So the hypothesis for us, we have two hypotheses, like knowledge, attitude, and burden of care score of family caregiver toward Alzheimer patient will be changed after the intervention. And the participant demographic background will significantly affect their knowledge, attitude, and burden toward having Alzheimer patients. So the conceptual framework we have, okay, we consider that we have caregiver determinants, including age, gender, residence area, level of education, and the degree of relativeness to the patients, affecting their knowledge about Alzheimer, their attitude toward the beloved one having this Alzheimer, and to what extent they feel burdened and loaded regarding providing care. All of these affected by implementing the educational intervention targeting all independent variable change. And we consider that if we give this information or give this awareness, okay, when we conducted that, when we work on knowledge level, okay, score to be increased, okay, that it will improve their attitude and reflect their decreasing the feeling always burden loaded among caregivers. So the methodology we used a quasi-experimental design, since the researcher can actively ensure that the difference between pre and post of the participant are in fact equivalent. This design considered appropriate for establishing cause-effect relationship. And study area and setting we conducted at the Geriatric Society Association in Al-Muntazahat District, Jeddah, Saudi Arabia. This association, it's not only for people having Alzheimer. It's for all elderly. So this is why we select from among them, yeah, the people having those or caring with Alzheimer patient from the people attending this association. This is the only center available in Jeddah for managing elderly people in general. The function of this association is to provide services for 300 old age patients and their family caregiver. And the objective of this association is to prevent elderly health from deteriorating, assisting them with geriatric disease management, provide all necessary support for them, conduct activities and the program for their psychotherapy, and provide education for their family caregiver. And we use three tools, okay, or four main tools. First, an instrument to assess demographic background for the participant, okay, asking them about their age, marital status, level of education, and if they have previously attended workshop regarding Alzheimer or not. The second one is the Alzheimer disease knowledge scale, which measure knowledge about Alzheimer disease. It was developed by Carpenter 2009, considering that it includes like 30 statements, okay, in true false item. And the higher score is indicative greater knowledge about this Alzheimer, okay, including or outlining the five main elements like risk factors, assessment and diagnosis, symptoms, life impact, caregiving, and treatment management. And the dementia attitude scales developed by Connor and McFadden for measuring the attitude toward dementia. This tool, family caregiver will be asked to rate their perception of people with Alzheimer's disease and related dementia, asking about their feeling toward those population. The tool is self-administered, consists of 20 items on Likert scales from strongly agree to strongly disagree, as total score ranges between 20 and 40, and more than 27 indicate that a person has positive attitude toward Alzheimer. And the last one is burden scale for family caregiver, developed by Russell and co-worker 2014, which include 10 items to measure subjective burden. Each item will be given a rate from strongly disagree, agree, and strongly agree, and caregiver subjective burden is higher when the degree of agreement is high. In data collection procedure, we receive permission from the CONGI research units, then KMARC, then IRB, and for data collection process to begin. All family caregiver enrolled with the Geriatric Association was notified about the study and they had been invited to participate. I remember we gave leaflets and a brief explanation and discussion about what was going to run. Okay, and the association manager prepares the patient list name in a sampling frame. When using the table to allocate study group, families of Alzheimer patients were identified by their code number. And then receiving the consent from a group to participate in the educational program. And we conducted in 3 hours block every other day for 2 weeks. Each session lasted 45 to 60 minutes and covering the following objective. We try to educate family caregiver about Alzheimer's disease. We help them to recognize the potential risk factor and causes of Alzheimer's disease. And we try to enable the family caregiver to apply different stress management and behavioral technique to manage their beloved patient communication and stress management technique. The program was conducted as 3 hours blocked, okay, every other day. And as I mentioned, each session lasted for 45 to 60 minutes into 6 sessions as follows. First session, it including filling a brief test questionnaire, explain the purpose and the plans for the program, identify the caregiver concern, what they feel, okay, regarding them, and to talk about feedback, what they know about this Alzheimer and so on. And then we start the second session, defining Alzheimer, list difference between Alzheimer and dementia. We talk about warning signals of Alzheimer, explain what about Alzheimer stage, and we start to listen from them regarding that at which stage their beloved one they have, they are in and the problems they face, okay. And we discuss also pharmacological and non-pharmacological treatment modalities with, for Alzheimer patient. And then we try to help the participant in applying strategy to deal with meeting basic needs. As you know, patient with Alzheimer, they lose everything. They completely become dependent in hygiene, cleanliness, in feeding. And they been experienced with hallucination and delusion. So we try to decrease burden by teaching them how to handle the patient, how to deal with this hallucination, because a lot of them, they discuss this, they listen that they found them, they are talking to themselves, they are complaining from that someone wanna hurting them. Sometimes the maid came and bought this and this and this, okay, so we try to help them and discuss for them how to handle hallucination, how to handle delusion, how to deal with this sleep pattern disturbance. And especially when they talk about that, the symptom become very worse regarding the sundown syndrome and the sleep pattern problem. In the fifth session, we discuss how caregiver can deal with their feeling of loneliness. Now we'll start to work on the caregivers themselves. They feel lonely, they feel depressed, sometimes they feel guilty regarding that they are not enabled, even their feelings that they feel burdened by presence of this patient with Alzheimer in their family. Okay, so we started to try to calm down or make them calm down, okay, regarding this guilt feeling, depression, and we explain for them how they can manage themselves regarding using stress management technique, by sharing their responsibility with others, person, okay, and apply like time out technique for them and help family to identify how to access the services present in the community. And lastly, in the last session, we listen for their feedback, encourage them to ask a question, evaluate the program from their point of view, and summarizing the main point, we give it and ask them to fill the post questionnaire. And then we try to do like data management for our data collected, okay, descriptive statistic were used to represent discrete variables as a frequency, percentage, and interval and ratio variables as mean and standard deviation, and for comparison of knowledge evaluation item mean between pre and post, we used independent sample t-test. And moreover, pre and post test score of family caregiver were analyzed using PER t-test. And the association between participant socio-demographic and their knowledge attitude was tested by using a statistical test, and significance level was tested on B less than 0.05. Okay. And then for ethical consideration, a formal approval was sought from research unit, KMARC IRB, and later also submitted for the approval for Geriatric Society Association manager. And then short explanation was given for a study participant, okay, regarding that, what's gonna run through the study and for how long they can be with us. And a lot of them, you know, they asked many questions, they have many queries regarding how they can care, for how long they will be in this, what is the life expectancy period for them. All this is answered or was answered for them, okay, as well as we ensure for them that everything will be confidential, anonymous during the study, and they have the complete freedom to withdraw from the study at any time they want. And now we'll go for the part of results. Okay, we have like 80 participants. Okay, majority of them less than between 20, less than 30. Marital status, they are single. Education, the majority is like in middle school. Bachelor degree, sorry, 27.5%, and only 3 participants have master degree. Family member have or had Alzheimer or dementia. Okay, the majority mentioned that they don't have, but they want to listen about this caring person. They attend or not attend, okay, a majority they said no. As I mentioned before, there is no awareness program allowed conducted in the association. And regarding the support group or educational program group, also majority did not attend. And regarding working voluntarily or not, okay, more than half of the sample, they mentioned no, they are not working before. And regarding the distribution of the study subject according to knowledge, pre and post, as you see, there is a significant difference between a total mean score of knowledge in pre and post. Okay, and regarding the Alzheimer disease knowledge, which is rated in poor, fair, good, dementia attitude also was significant difference between, even the burden of the caregiver, okay, decreased after the educational program. And regarding the association between the study subject Alzheimer disease knowledge level and their socio-demographic, okay, age, one of the factors that affecting the level of knowledge, okay, marital status also, there is significant difference, and the educational level also, there is a significant difference. When we go for the presence of family member having this, okay, it seems like there is no significant difference. Okay, the same like...
Professor Amal, you have 3 minutes left of your time now.
Okay. So we'll go quickly for this attitude level. Okay, also there is significant difference regarding age, marital status, okay, and educational level. Okay, and item regarding working with previously working with Alzheimer patient or having a Alzheimer patient in the family. Okay, and regarding the correlation matrix, okay, between knowledge, attitude, and burden, okay, we found that there is a significant correlation between the attitude and Alzheimer level of knowledge and the burden, which is affected by a negative way. And as far as the knowledge increases, attitude is improved. Now the whole, like the burden level become decreased. In conclusion, the studied subject knowledge, attitude, and the burden level were improved post-intervention and with statistical significant difference. And there is a statistical significant association noted between studied subject level regarding Alzheimer age, marital status, level of education, attendance of support group. And there is a statistically significant association noted between studied subjected dementia-related attitude, their age, marital status, attendance, as it was mentioned in the result. And finally, there is a weak positive significant relation between a studied subject knowledge level attitude regarding dementia, as well with weak positive significant relation between a study subject caregiver burden and the attitude regarding dementia, whereas there is no correlation noted between knowledge level and caregiver burden with no statistical significant difference. Therefore, we recommend a well-planned and structured educational program should be undertaken to improve level of awareness and contribute to a better understanding of Alzheimer and dementia, and conducting community awareness campaign based on the pre-assessment for the community need to talk about this dementia and using issue guideline, using a mass media to broadcast all relevant culturally acceptable healthy message about this Alzheimer and the importance of supporting them, and future study could investigate the correlation between level of caregiver awareness regarding Alzheimer and their health condition and burden. And for the implication, it's highly important to communicate the results for the current study with manager and stockholder to attain a deep insight regarding long-term usefulness of Alzheimer caregiver support and its benefit. And we have to communicate the results also for policymaker and rehabilitation team at all level to be aware by the results of this study and focusing on enhancing, raising awareness of public toward Alzheimer, considered when they are going to write their strategy improvement plan, and creating a caregiver support group for those who are new Alzheimer disease caregiver must be encouraged. And that's it. Thank you.